Hello my friends of Hatari Labs, my name is Saul Montoya, welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial will be a tutorial on a practical way to convert a PDF into a SRich file. I mean, how can we extract spatial data from a PDF? A normal PDF, not a geospatial PDF. So how we do this? You're going to receive the compressed version of this folder, okay, where you have the PDF that is a map. Okay, I will open here. So this is the map. Okay, and in order to do the extraction of these lines, these polylines, we need to convert the PDF into DXF. Okay, so first let's put some first convert from PDF to DXF with Inkscape. Okay, great. So with Inkscape we open the PDF, okay, and this can take a while. And once you have opened the PDF, you also save us in the same place. We strongly recommend that you place the folder that we provide to you in your documents, because actually works better there for the Anaconda, for the Python scripting. And then you place it here, but instead of SVG, instead of PDF, you will use as a DXF. Okay, and this can take a while. I mean, to open this can take 4 minutes, and to save this can take also 3 or 4 minutes. Okay, so just be patient on this step. Okay, and after that you can close your Inkscape. Okay, as you know, Inkscape is also open source software, so actually no, you don't need any license to do this. Okay, well, great, so you have already on Inkscape. Okay, and then the next thing that you are going to do is, you know, you need to work with we are going to work with JupyterLab, okay, because on other tutorials I have used Jupyter Notebook. JupyterLab is more handy, has more tools if you want to do more stuff. Okay, so we open JupyterLab, so we go to Anaconda Prop, or you just go here to your Anaconda PowerShell, okay, CD documents, because actually we are in documents. Okay, CD, how to convert PDF. Okay, and then here I launch JupyterLab just to be on the root. Okay, just to be here and to see these three folders where when JupyterLab is being launched. Okay, for people that actually will deal with this, with this stuff, we strongly recommend to follow this procedure with the data provided here. Okay, why? Wait. Wait. I need my raw script. No. Okay. I need to. Okay. I will delete this. Delete. Yeah. And okay. So this is what actually you will be stored here. You go to scripts. You will be placed here. You go to scripts, and here you just place a new notebook. Okay. This is a new notebook. Okay. Great. Great so far. Yes. Uh, We strongly recommend that you follow this procedure with the data provided here because it can be that for your data you need some special tweaking, you need some special consideration, so on. So you would be frustrated if you do this on the beginning, I mean with your own data, because unless you know Python, you're fluent with Python and GeoPandas and other stuff, you will be struggling a lot. So in order for you to provide a good learning curve, we strongly advise that you follow this procedure with the data here, and then you understand what is going on, and then you deal with the data that you want to place. Okay, great. PDF. Okay, great. So what do we need? First of all, what do we need is to do matplotlib online. Then you need import matplotlib pyplot as plt, import GeoPandas. If you don't have GeoPandas installed, just type pip install GeoPandas on Anaconda prompt, or conda install GeoPandas, whatever it works for you, because it actually depends on your operating system and your Anaconda version. Okay, run. Okay. It's matplotlib inline. Sorry, it's too early in the morning. Okay, then we are going to open the DXF. So plano is equal to gpd dot read file, and then where we are going to read on the PDF folder, and how it's called, plano camagmayo DXF. I use the tab for the auto completion tool. Okay, and then I can plot where. With a fixed size of 20 by 40. Okay, with this I can plot them. Okay, so actually what do I have is I have all the spatial data of my DX file on Jupyter Notebook, and this is very handy because so far I haven't used any other software, but now I'm going to open QAS. Okay, why I'm going to open QAS? Because in this procedure, I need the position on pixels of a certain point where I know the coordinates. Okay, and what is this? I mean, why do I need that? If you work with QAS, and then if you do the georeferencing of raster files, that you correlate a position on the image to a known position on the a position on the image to a known position already known position in the coordinate in the map, is the same but with vector data. Okay, so for example, I will use this, I mean the intersection in between this line, because I know which is the coordinate of this. Okay, so in my QAS, I will open I create a new project. I go to my documents, and then to the folder, I go to PDF, and I open the DXF. Okay, here is the DXF, and then I need the line strings only. Okay, I know which is the coordinate of this one, of this and this. Okay, so I will go here and I will place here, and because it's in geographical coordinates, but since it wasn't provided the system of reference, this is just XY, I mean not real geospatial position on the world, okay? Because actually you don't have these coordinates in the real world. Okay, so I go to vector coordinate capture. I will start my capture. I will go here, and I want to okay, here, this is my coordinates, okay? So this is my coordinate, okay? Okay, I need this coordinate for my next step. Which is my next step? I'm going to translate. I'm going to do a partial translation. Partial translation. And which will be my partial translation? That I will place the 0, 0 that is here, I will place it here because I need this in order to do the georeferential. Okay? Okay. The coordinates actually are these ones, but I will need to translate in the opposite direction. Okay, so from 0 I will need to translate this 270 pixels to the right, and I will need to translate this minus 149 pixels down. So I will do this plano translate and the opposite of this. So it will be this and this. It's the opposite of this. Okay, great. So, and say partial translation dot plot of fixed size equals to 20.40 tilt dot grid. Okay, so I will run this and I will show you that it has already translated where the origin or the 0.0 it will be here. So this is the same, but 0 and 0 is here. Okay, I have already the translated. I mean, I need this in order to scale and to translate it again. Okay, but you will see this before later on. Okay. Then I will use a scale. Why I have to use a scale? Because this is in pixels, yeah. But I need this in meters. But I know that each of these squares or each of the distance in between these horizontal and vertical lines is 150 meters. I mean, I can get this from the 1,500 meters. I can get this from the map, from the drawing, from the PDF. Okay, so what I will do is actually I will go here, I will select degrees, and then I need to as close as possible. You can do this, so this will be in my drawing will be, I need this in degrees. In my drawing, this will be 509 degrees. Okay, let's. Okay, 510 degrees. Excuse me a sec. Okay, in my drawing will be 510 degrees, but actually in reality is 4 kilometers, 500 meters. So what are we going to do is I will do a scale that is 4,500 meters divided by 510. Okay, so this is the value of the scale so far. I mean, you can tweak, you can do a better measurement of the distance in the GIS. Okay, so this is just for the purpose of the tutorial. So geometry scale is equal to partial translation. Actually, geometry scale, partial translation are data frames from GeoPandas. Scale of scale, this is the scale on x direction, this is the scale on the y direction, on the z direction is the same, where the origin is equal to 0,0,0, because actually I have done the translation before. I mean, I have done the translation that actually this is my origin, okay? And then you will see which is the relevance of this in the next step, okay? So this is the scale geometry, and then you say the geometry translated is equal to geometry scale translate, because I will translate this point to the actual geospatial. I will translate this point to the actual geospatial position. Okay? Okay, so this line scale the drawing, and this line translate the drawing with this origin to the actual position, to the actual coordinates of this. Okay, so this is translate. Okay, and if you get this, is the, you can go to the PDF, but the coordinates of this is 299 and 83 50 500, okay, and 0. So with this, because if you go to the drawing, so this is the coordinate 83 50 500, because it's this point 83 50 500 249 000. Okay, this is the coordinate, and this is the coordinate we place here. Okay, so just run the cell. And then I can plot my geometry translated dot plot. This is fixed size equals to 20 times 40. And then say PLT dot grid, just to see the position. Okay, and then if we run this, we get the position. Okay, great. So we see, I mean, this actually coincides with this, and this line coincides with this. This is a fraction, so that actually the grid, because as you remember, is every 1,500 meters, and this is every 1,000 meters. Okay, but you see, okay, that the fit is relative great, good. Okay, and now what else we are going to do, that we are going to export the data. Okay, Okay, so we create a special data frame is equal to GPD geopandas GPD dot geo data frame where is a plano because plano is the plano is the data frame and the geometry is the actual data frame that we opened from the DXF, but the geometry is different because it's geometry translated. Okay, this is the geometry and let's say plano let's say spatial DX CRS. Actually I gave the CRS, but when I export the data I have to assign it again on the QES because it doesn't write the PRG file, the projection file, or the CUPRG file. Okay, well, just for information, this is EPSG is PESAT 80 is PESAT 56 SON 19S. So the EPSG is this one. You need the EPSG later, and then say okay, and then you can plot it, but actually we don't want to plot it. Yes, okay, and then we are going to export as a shape file. How we export as a shape file? Let's say df lines is equal to spatial df where spatial df geometry, we are going to do a filter here, type equals to line string, because we are not going to export the our shape. I mean, if you remember, a shape file can have weather, points, lines and polygons, but can have both. So in this we do a filter where we only want lines, because the DXF has also points. Okay, so this is the filter. So df lines to file. Okay, and then where we are going to place it, we are going to place it here in shapes. And say here will be df lines dot shp. So if we run this, we have a problem here as geo data frame. Okay, it's working, and actually it's doing its stuff here, because there are many lines. Actually, this is going to, if I know, okay, it's around 50 megabytes or something like that. So we go to our, and then here on the shape file I have my DX file that has no system of reference, but as I have said on the script, I have to assign this, and which it will be 24709 24. Okay, EPSG 24. Wow, a ver, ese pesa 56. UTM. Okay. Okay. Is 809 is 879 is 879. So actually I will is 879. It doesn't matter. I mean, for the script it do not. I mean, if you were going to do some stuff in GeoPandas, you correct this, but so far this is just to correct my, when you export this to QIS, actually loses this. Okay, so that's why you have to reassign on QIS. Okay, great. So if we go to zoom to layer, this is our stuff. And how do we know that we are in the right position? Okay, because we are going to use an XYZ tile of Google Satellite. For the people that do not know how to get this, because actually it's really handy, you just have to make this connection with these parameters. Okay, just put a place and we have a tutorial on that as well. Okay, so we get a Google Satellite and then we place it here. Okay, and that's it. We see, okay, I like to put this on a very more yellow. Okay, and then okay, we can do some. Okay, there is some, I mean, still we cannot assure that the Google Satellite is actually right. I mean, it has also an offset. Okay, so the better way that you need to georeference this is with a Sentinel image or like any geospatial position points on this on surface or so. But so far the fitness is great. I mean, and then on the code you can do your own calibration of the parameters of the scales and so on. Okay, but you see, for example, there are some. Okay, this circle is actually here, so you have a gap of on this. I mean, that is actually not the of 20 meters, but you need to in order to have the real position, you needed to do it with a. You need to do this with the position of with GPS position. So, okay, but so far if you want the everything here is aligned. The attribute table it doesn't give you much information on something because this is, but you get the lines. I mean, you can do the position, you can extract, you can do filtering and so on here, or maybe you can recreate the topography. Okay, but this is great because you can get the rivers, you can get the I mean, with more work, you can get the stages and so on of this with just something that is published on the web, or with that just something that someone provided and has not the capabilities to provide you the original data because it's lost, because it's dependent on other authorities and so on. Okay? Okay, I hope that this tutorial is helpful for you. It was a pleasure for me to have provided this. Because it's more practical work, on coming tutorials we are going to do more groundwater. but this is something that we deal in most of us when we do projects or like environmental studies. Okay, my name is Saul Montoya, we are from Hatari Labs. We are a blog dedicated to knowledge sharing open source software, especially in groundwater modeling. It was a pleasure for you to have you in the tutorial, and hope to see you in coming tutorial. If you like this, just give it a like to the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and share it through your social networks. Okay, have a great day, and bye bye.